Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this morning is Charles Gordon, Head of Investor Relations at Hochschild Mining. Charles, it's good to see you. How are you today?
Very good. Thank you very much, Christine.
Charles, to start us off with, just give us a brief intro into the company for investors who might not be familiar with it.
Yes, Hochschild Mining is a precious metal producer, silver and gold. We mine Latin American. We've been around for over 100 years now, actually, and we've been mining for well over 50 years of that. We have three current mines, all of them, two of them actually in Peru, and they're 100% owned, and they're all underground narrow vein deposits producing both gold and silver. We then have 51% of a Argentinian mine called San Jose in the south of the country. The other 49% is owned by a company called McEwen Mining. The key asset really is the Aclara asset, which is our flagship gold. It mostly produces gold, actually, this one, has a bit of silver in southern Peru. Very low cost competitive position, lots of potential to find many, many more ounces there. And it actually provides us with roughly 70 to 80% of our free cash flow. So that's kind of the basic company. We're listed in London, obviously. We've got lots of brownfield potential, greenfield exploration potential and projects throughout all the Americas. We do concentrate not just on South America, where obviously we've been around for a long time, but also on North America. We're very keen on expanding our position there.
Before we talk about interim half-year results highlights there, I want to talk about the potential rare earths opportunity you have in Chile. Tell us more about that.
Yeah, so about 3 or 4 years ago, Christine, we said to ourselves that as a company that was extremely well established in South America, a lot of opportunities came across our desk and which we potentially didn't always look at in other metals, not just in precious metals. And so we started to think about, were there any metals that we felt had excellent demand characteristics going forward that we felt we could add value in? And one set of metals was rare earths. We also looked at things like lithium, cobalt, scandium, but rare earths was something we considered. And this project in Chile, used to be called Biolantanidos. Now we've just renamed it in the last week, Aclara. It's a very, very intriguing project. Rare earths, as you may know, are not actually rare. But the rare earths themselves, which are quite rare, are called heavy rare earths. And they're absolutely crucial elements you need for the electric revolution in things like electric cars, drones, wind turbines. So all across that electric revolution, you need these heavy rare earths that go into the permanent magnets that go into all these applications. And we have a deposit in Chile, which we've just released our first set of information on in the last week. And it's called an ionic clay deposit. It's a very, very competitive source of heavy rare earths, very low cost, and rarely found outside China. China, as you may know, is the dominant producer and consumer of rare earths in the world. And so finding a deposit outside China is quite difficult. And finding one that is extremely environmentally friendly, so it has no radioactivity, which can be a real issue with a lot of rare earth producers. And let me tell you, there's not too many of those outside China. So it's fantastic deposit. We've just released in the last week, we released some PEA, so preliminary economic assessment numbers. It looks like a pretty profitable project. And crucially, we're going to develop it in a modular stage. We're going to start with a small first module, which has a good positive NPV, and then we will look to expand it using a very, very large land package that we have. So it's very exciting. It's obviously different to gold and silver, but a very exciting market and one that, you know, we could push the button on starting construction in the next year or so.
In the next year. Okay, we'll look forward to that. And besides that, from my understanding, a potential gold project in Canada as well?
Yes, we have a very interesting option that expires next month, actually, on a project called SNIP, which is in British Columbia in Canada. That option is to earn 60%. Currently, the deposit is being explored by a company called Skeena Resources. It was actually a past producing mine in the 1990s, very high grade. It announced a maiden gold resource, just gold project this, just over a year ago. We have this option that expires in the middle of next month. And if we decide to take it up, then we would have to spend roughly double what they've spent in exploration up till now, which would be about 60 million over a number of years. A very exciting high grade option for the company in the sort of midterm. You could expect to see production in that over the next 3 or 4 years. So we're quite excited by it. We're just doing all the sort of due diligence work at the moment, but hopefully we'll have a decision on that quite soon.
We'll follow up on that. And I do want to get to your interim half year results. In your opinion, what stood out to you?
Well, I think the thing with our company, and look, everyone has been experiencing this worldwide. You know, we were hugely impacted last year by COVID. At one point in April last year, we had all of our operations stopped due to the virus. So what you've seen in this first half of the year, in the first half of 2021, you've seen a big, big rebound from the numbers from last year. So you saw revenue was up 70% to just nearly touching $400 million. You saw EBITDA up well over almost 150% to nearly $200 million. The cash balance is growing as well strongly. And we also announced an interim dividend as well. So I think the company's is in really good financial health. I think we've had a really good first half, hit our production targets. We're on track to produce our target for the year in production and costs. So, and as well as that, we also had a really good start to the year in terms of our exploration, the exploration we're doing in and around our deposits to find more life of mine. And that started very well, especially at Immaculata.
Also, earlier this summer, you did begin trading on the OTCQX here in New York. Are you hoping to attract more U.S. investors?
Absolutely. We've always believed, although listed in London, we've always believed that the story is something that resonates with North American investors. You know, obviously, the mines are currently in South America, but even just thinking about the time zone helps, doesn't it? So I think we've always looked to the north. We would love to have operations, as I said earlier, in Canada or in the United States. So for us, it feels like a story that has a natural home in you know, with the US retail investors. Obviously, the US retail investors know a lot about gold and silver, especially silver. And there's a number of companies they're used to. But we think that, you know, Hochschild provides a few different growth options. And we think it's a story that, you know, probably has yet to be tapped in the US, maybe outside the sort of major centers of sort of New York and Boston.
Well, certainly lots going on for you, and really looking forward to following the story here. Charles, thank you so much for the time.
No problem. Thanks very much, Christine.